Case conceptualization is probably one of the most important competencies in counseling practice, or as far as training therapists, because it's really a map for understanding why things are happening and how we actually help people get better, considering things like culture, considering things like their personality, their past history of trauma or adverse experiences. So really, it's a process for helping people know how to best treat those interventions and understanding why they're occurring and how we can actually help people move towards more adaptive functioning. Case conceptualization is a systematic process for how therapists or graduate students in training who are studying psychology or counseling, it's for how do they think like a counselor, how do they think like a therapist, how do they make sense of why human suffering occurs through different theoretical models, and then how do they actually treat individuals with different presenting problems like depression, anxiety, different disorders that are in the DSM-5. We look at how do we actually help people and treat them, but also how do we conceptualize why have they developed some of those patterns and why have they developed some of those symptoms.
You know, when we talk about what makes you competent, we always think of clinicians like you need to be able to talk to somebody, you need to make someone feel comfortable, and consider building rapport as one of the most important competencies, one of the most important things that we do. But I could be a really nice person and build rapport with you, but I might not be able to do anything effective with you. A case conceptualization is a roadmap. By being able to do an effective case conceptualization, you know where you think about the client, you know where to put together a treatment plan and what to follow. It also allows, because of the way effective case conceptualization is done, it allows for you to work collaboratively with the client and make changes. All of our students, when they go out into the world, having this skill will be a skill that they will appreciate forever and use always.
For me, I like to think of it as summarizing the concept of the client itself and the situation. It gives me a good background about the client itself, himself or herself, as far as like any family history, things that may have occurred that the client may have tendencies to do, and gives me an idea for future diagnosis as well.
Right, so it takes that background information and it takes the symptoms, and what it does do is it organizes it in a way. It organizes all these pieces of information because there are so many. Imagine somebody coming in to see you and they're in pain or in crisis. They have so much to tell you. How do you put it all together except saying, well, this is what he said and this is what he said? We have to put it together in some kind of a cohesive format. And that format is really what we call a conceptualization.
It's a map and a cognitive understanding of how and why things are occurring. It's a rationale for why we do what we do in talk therapy and why we don't do, maybe a rationale for what we don't do in counseling. So it really is a map for how do we incorporate our understandings of individuals' mental health, whether it's culture, whether it's personality, whether it's different theoretical ways of understanding why human suffering occurs. So very much an important competency. It's probably up there with the importance of the therapeutic alliance or the relationship that counselors create with their clients.
We've had to incorporate writing papers on case conceptualization, and when using it with my clients, I think that what I do is it helps me to formulate the proper treatment plan for them and diagnosis, because a lot of times clients come in and they might be saying that they're depressed or that they have anxiety, but until you actually start doing a conceptualization and you take into consideration the intake interview, the mental status exam, and you know, the first one or two sessions with the client, there may be something that's underlying within the diagnosis that you might want to pay more attention to that you wouldn't have if you didn't do a case conceptualization.
So I think that the process is an important process from a new to a seasoned clinician. It is the process of putting all the information together. It also shows you where you're lacking information. So if there's more information you need to understand a client or understand what's going on, it helps you identify those places. But most importantly, although we consider treatment part of the formulation, you can't do an effective treatment formulation if you don't have the other components of the case conceptualization in order. So if you don't understand where the client's coming from, you don't understand those symptoms and what perpetuates, keeps those going, it's really harder to come up with treatment. Treatment becomes more hit and miss. And this keeps it really efficient and beneficial to the client.
There are many benefits that I've seen. Although it's time consuming, I think it's really important going into the practice of becoming a psychotherapist. So it really helps in understanding the client and what types of treatments you can incorporate with that client based on how well they would respond to certain treatments. You would take multicultural aspects into account. You really get to know the client when you're going through it. Sometimes we have selective hearing and we can't remember everything. So by looking at all the different elements between the mental status exam, the intake interview, the first couple of sessions, and you're thinking about all these different pieces that are incorporated in the case conceptualization, you know, you start to be able to map everything out in a planned way so that by the time you get to the treatment plan, you kind of have an idea of where you're going with it, and now you have an actionable plan.
Whenever we work with our students who are graduate students, one of the important things is how do they see and understand their client? Case conceptualization is really all about that. It's the formal process of understanding a client. It's not just the history of the client, because those pieces are important components of a case conceptualization, but having really a floor plan of what to do with a client.
What it does is it really helps you to make the proper diagnosis, and it incorporates the type of personality traits that the client has. They're either avoidant personality or dependent, or what would they respond to? Where's their comfort level? Do they need medication? Do they not need medication? Are they being treated for that now? You get to get an idea of where they are at in the process, and you try to meet the client's needs according to how well they would respond. By the time you get down to the treatment plan, you have a really good idea of where you're going with that. So you're not only thinking about the things that, you know, might work well for the client as far as treatment is concerned, but you're also taking into account their personality and how well they would respond to the treatment that you're providing them with.
So really the cause of human suffering could be looked at through a case conceptualization lens, looking at what different theories explain why human suffering occurs, and then how do they formulate that, or how do they organize that information? A biomedical explanation of depression can be that someone has chemical imbalance in their brain, and perhaps that was a genetic factor, or that was, they inherited those genes from their parents. That understanding is just one understanding of hundreds of different counseling theories and personality theories out there, that we look at case conceptualization as answering the question with some tentative ideas, but we're looking at how does a different theory explain through their lens why human suffering occurs. Our cognitive psychology, people would talk about that people suffer because of the way they perceive information, that our stressful situations don't lead to our suffering, it's our interpretations of those stressful situations. So case conceptualization is a way of how do you organize that information, answer the question to why are they feeling the way they're feeling, or why have they developed their interpersonal pattern the way that they have, and then therefore how can we help them improve and maybe move towards higher or better functioning.
Yeah, it gives me a general overview of the client. It can go anything from stemming from different theories, which is very important actually. What we will do is that we'll address it based on different theories, which allow us to have different approaches to how we'll determine how to effectively, you know, deal with the client. So we can use a particular concept that we'll learn in class, and then we'll come up with a completely different backstory of how we need to approach that particular client. Even though the story and everything will be the same, we'll have a different approach to it through behavioral or cognitive development or so forth. It gives me a good idea personally to kind of think of what approach that we use will be best effective for that particular client.
So case conceptualization is typically done throughout all of the treatment process, but it also is focused primarily in the beginning of treatment as well. So in the beginning intake and rapport building process that's happening, it's looking at all of the information the client is giving us and starting to come up with an initial hypothesis, an initial conceptualization or formulation, it's also called, for what the client's presenting with and what explanation or influencing factors may be at play as far as why they're feeling the way they're feeling. We typically do that initial intake with very specific questions in mind of trying to make sense of the client's experience of their problems or symptoms or difficulties, but throughout treatment we're continuing to confirm our hypotheses or readjust and make some different hypotheses.
For example, in class we've done some case on the Iceman, and we've used many different theories as far as like approaches concerned. And for me, the behavioral approach, I think, is probably the most effective from what I've seen through other counselors and other psychologists with their interactions and interviews with that particular individual. I think that having the broad idea of having different concepts and different backgrounds or theories will help you kind of assess like how to specifically deal with a particular client and their particular issues.
Essentially, almost most of the competencies that individuals learn in counseling are really centered around case conceptualization. So I think that's why it's so important. It's really connected to so much of how we make sense of what's going on with individuals, their culture, our ethical codes, to the biomedical side of chemical imbalances in the brain. Or case conceptualization is actually tied to all of these different clinical techniques or processes that we do, like a mental status exam, because it gives us data about the client that helps us understand what's going on with them, whether it's a diagnosis or symptoms, or whether it's some specific deficit that they're presenting.
So at first it was extremely intimidating having to do the very long case conceptualizations, but it's really helped for me to formulate treatment plan and understand the client's past to help them. I am able to now see a client in a complete different light. I'm able to figure out where everything came from, originated from, their childhood and their issues that they're having and what they're troubled with, and help formulate why it's happening and put it into perspective with treatment.
A floor plan of what to do with a client. So the case conceptualization process, in my experience, is actually a difficult skill to teach, but probably the most valuable one that our students will have. So in my experience, it's been trying to teach that the difference between just summarizing a client and conceptualizing them, understanding them.
In the beginning of counseling, there's usually the process of like a rapport building or relationship building. But then after that, we immediately move into that intake and assessment process where we're asking questions and organizing data about the client. And case conceptualization is actually tied right in that process. So after we build a rapport with the client and we start to gather information about them, we start to formulate a hypothesis for perhaps why they're presenting symptoms have developed and perhaps how personality plays into that or how that factors into that. So very much a organizing of data process that happens in case conceptualization, which is just the first step of case conceptualization.
Seeing them in terms of not only their symptoms, their competencies, their strengths, their resources, and putting it all together in a way that makes sense to the clinician, the person who's working with the client, and really to the client as well. And so understanding what your treatment plan is going to be.
When it comes to diagnosis, there's definitely different schools of thought about, do we talk to our clients about a diagnosis? In some cases, agencies may not require a diagnosis because maybe philosophically they don't see a value in it or a little clinical utility in it. But for example, if you're seeing a therapist who takes insurance, typically an actual diagnosis needs to be provided. So one thing that I think is really important is not so much about the client knows their actual diagnosis, but it's often actually that we ask them and assess what is their understanding of what's going on. Because many people come in with their belief about, okay, I have anxiety or I'm depressed. So case conceptualization is related to that because we care actually about the client's perception of what the cause of the problem is, of what they believe might be going on, and what is their conceptualization of the problem. So think if a therapist has their conceptualization that a client is depressed because of A, B, and C, and the client believes they're depressed because of E, G, and Z, we know that those mismatching conceptualization will probably lead to the client not getting better. Case conceptualization, the different theories or the different manualized treatments will be determined by the way we assess and organize information about a client. So if I'm doing cognitive behavioral therapy, I will ask questions in the intake and the assessment process that are general biographical and demographic questions. But then I'll also ask questions that are regarding that theory. So I'll ask questions about how they perceive and think things, what their automatic thoughts are, what some of, you know, get an understanding of some of their core beliefs and schemas. And then therefore, through that conceptualization model and my understanding of the client through a cognitive behavioral lens, I'm going to typically use cognitive behavioral interventions to actually affect change with the client or to help them move towards some goal, whether it's feeling less depressed or more satisfied with life or having fewer relationship difficulties or conflicts.
We're about to address this, we're moving in this direction, and they immediately start talking about what happened over the weekend and that something that was really upsetting them occurred. And then we start talking the next session, and then they start talking about something else. And it's not suggesting that what people say in counseling shouldn't be talked about, but there's actually a lot of research that goes into what is the content that people bring up in therapy, and they've even given words like therapeutic rabbits or red herrings.
So prognosis is discussed in case conceptualization because we're looking at how do we make sense of the client's presenting issues and what is the likelihood that they perhaps will bounce back or improve over time. In a full case conceptualization statement, a prognosis, especially in a case report, a prognosis would be discussed as far as the client being judged to have a good prognosis, a fair prognosis, or a guarded prognosis. So let's say for drug treatment, interventions like motivational interviewing might be useful, but when someone comes in a stage of being ready to change and really motivated for therapy, things like cognitive behavioral strategies like behavioral activation and cognitive restructuring, those kind of techniques are the kinds we'd use with clients who are ready for change in those action stage of change or preparation stage. Case conceptualization is about having a rationale for what you're doing, the techniques or interventions or strategies a person's doing, but then also it's a rationale for why you've chosen not to do certain techniques or why you've chosen not to go a certain line of questioning or interventions. So knowing why we're doing and what we're doing it is what this is about, and having a thoughtful, well-planned intervention is what case conceptualization is about. So I'm hoping that through this video people can know a little bit about what the meaning is of the conceptualization process, and that it is really applying theories to application and working with clients. So understanding why they're feeling the way they're feeling, and then also connecting interventions to how we formulate treatment.